My name is Tim Grove, and I'm a faculty member at EAPS. I melt rocks at high pressures and high temperatures and try to understand how the interiors of planetary bodies form and how they evolve through time. The recent work that Bernard Charlier and myself and Maria did on Mercury, we had this unique opportunity to take a chemical composition of a rock that was returned by an instrument on a spacecraft using an X-ray fluorescence measurement. So we couldn't go to the surface of the planet. Goodness knows it'll be a long time before we ever hit Mercury, right? But we could actually get the chemical composition of this rock from the remote measurement made by the spacecraft, and then we could go into my lab, and I have all of the ingredients that you need to make up the composition of that rock. And then once we have that rock, we can do what we call melting experiments on it at different temperatures and different pressures, and we can understand the context of how that composition was formed by melting some pre-existing planetary material. And for a planet like Mercury, that's really tremendously exciting. We have only recently gotten compositional information from the surfaces of planets other than Earth. The Apollo mission in the moon, which I was fortunate enough to work on, we did exactly the same thing with the rocks on the surface of the moon. We had real rocks, so sometimes we could actually crush up a real rock. Sometimes we had a chemical composition and we could make it up in the lab and melt it, but we could understand the early melting, cooling, and chemical differentiation history of that parent body. And then Mars, we have samples of Mars, both meteorites that have fallen to the ground, but also all the rovers have returned chemical compositions of the surface rocks, which we've gone into the lab, made up the compositions, and then melted them to understand the thermal evolution of those rocks and what they mean about Mars' early history. On Mercury, the crust of Mercury, we can tell it's very, very old because it's intensely bombarded by meteorite impacts that on other planetary surfaces we know are somewhere between 3.6 and 3.9 billion years old. So the rocks have been hit 3.6 to 3.9 billion years ago, so we know that they're at least that old. And there we can take this rock and we can say, well, what was going on during that period of geologic time within Mercury. So it's, you know, a tremendously exciting opportunity to understand the melting and crystallization processes that were taking place in that parent body.